The Navajo Nation covers many parts of the United States. It extends into northeastern Arizona, southern Utah, and western New Mexico. It is the largest Indian reservation in the United States, nearing the size of the state of West Virginia. There are over 300,000 tribal members living on the reservation. Over the years, the Navajo, as well as many other tribes, have fought to preserve and protect their land. The Navajo have been subjected to many attempts by the United States government to use their land as a toxic waste dump facility. Many tribes and nations, like the Navajo, were not aware of the consequences of having a waste dump facility located on their reservation. In other cases, the government and agencies involved would lie about their actual plans and state that they were building a recycling plant. The United States government was able to convince many tribes and nations to agree to hosting these facilities by offering great benefits. In 1987, the U.S. Congress created the Office of Nuclear Waste Negotiator in an effort to open a federal monitored retrievable storage site for high-level nuclear waste. The negotiator sent letters to every federally recognized tribe in the country, offering hundreds of thousands and even millions of dollars to tribal council governments for first considering and then ultimately hosting the dump. Many tribal members had no money and no job. The United States government promised many jobs to those within the reservations at these facilities, knowing that they could take advantage of their poverty. The price the tribal members would pay for hosting these facilities would be nowhere close to what they would be receiving. Many tribal members that worked at these facilities experienced critical health problems due to radiation. When cases started to arise over these health issues, the tribal members demanded financial compensation for the damage done to their people and their land. The tribal members were not given financial compensation because the government believed it was their choice to work in the facilities and expose themselves to the radiation. Their land became consumed by radiation and no longer able to be used for farming or grazing. Today, much of this land remains undeveloped. In 1988, the Navajo people were offered a similar deal by Waste Tech Services and Pegler Welch Engineering to create a recycling plant on their land in Dilken, Arizona. After agreeing to the project, the Navajo people discovered that they had been lied to and that the project had actually been planned for a hazardous waste incinerator. The Navajo people educated themselves on the repercussions of such a dangerous facility through the organization CARE, Citizens Against Ruining the Environment. CARE was created by the Navajo people to combat the toxic waste dump issue. The Navajo organization informed its people of the risk factors involved with such a project before conducting a vote that would decide the status on the construction of the facility. After thorough educating, the Navajo people conducted a final vote from all citizens to decide who was for and who was against the construction of the waste facility. After a unanimous vote against it, tribal leaders were able to rescind the approval of the project. Due to their success, the Navajo organization later began to help other nations and tribes with the same problems and successfully helped them abolish plans for future waste dump facilities. The organization has now evolved into IEN, Indigenous Environmental Network, and works to enforce environmental justice for tribes and nations all across North America. IEN holds many informational meetings, organizes campaigns, and forms alliances with tribes and nations to make their organization stronger. Without the Navajo stepping in and standing up for their land and their people, this may have been an even more devastating issue for American Indians today.